Hello everyone, here I am again. So today I'm going to talk about how to make the right choice for the vlogging camera. I will make some suggestions based on my personal experience and also other people's stories regarding to these gears. So first of all, I started vlogging like 2 years ago, mainly to document my journey to California. I had a really good time there and the gear I chose is my iPhone 8 Plus. Because at that time, I was a beginner and a high school student. I don't have that much money to buy a proper camera. It turns out great, but I did a really ridiculous thing that I set my video format into 4K and also the highest frame rate, 120 frames per second. But I'm not sure, but it looks really high quality to me at that time. I love about vlogging on phone is that it is really easy to carry because everyone needs a phone and everyone brings a phone. If you just like pull off your phone and then shoot right there, it would be really convenient and a lot of people wouldn't judge you. For beginners, if you're like first start to shoot vlogs, I would definitely recommend to first use your phone. It is easy to carry, easy to control. Like few months later, I bought my first vlogging camera. It's the Canon G7X. It was super popular back then. I really loved that camera, but I sold it at the end of last year and then I switched to Sony ZV-1. Mainly because Leon persuaded me it was much better than the Canon G7X Mark II. So after a few months and I shot some video footage on ZV-1, so here's my comparison between Canon G7X Mark II and Sony ZV-1. I will show you a lot of footage I took. You can compare by yourself and choose the right camera for yourself. First of all, video quality. Both camera has really high video quality, but Sony ZV-1 is able to shoot 4K, which is slightly better. But why do you need 4K for your vlog? If you want to shoot 4K, it's your choice. And also comparing the color science, I personally love Canon better than Sony. It is much more natural, the skin tone looks better. You know, Sony have like that yellow, greenish skin tone. If you don't color grade later, it will look really weird. It's just really weird. I think Canon's skin tone is more towards pink, and ZV-1 definitely had less flattering. Requires more effort to do the post-production when you're editing. When I was shooting Canon, add some saturations and brighten it a little bit and then it's done. It will look good. But for Sony right now, I would use a HLG LUTs and then drag up the shadow and then add some green tint into it. It just like a lot of process. So for beginners, I would recommend Canon if you want that glowy, healthy, natural skin tone. And moving on to the audio part, the reason why I changed from Canon to Sony is that Canon G7X does not have the microphone, or you cannot connect to an extra microphone, but Sony has that feature. It has this little that cats come with it, looks like a hat on your camera. It will be really cute, but I just took it down and I don't know how to put it on there because I would usually shoot with a DAD dual microphone. I just don't need this stuff. So for the audio parts, G7X lose. But for beginners, if you're just recording your life, you don't need to have very high quality audio, G7X would be your choice. And then about the camera focus, like a lot of people switch from Canon to Sony is that the autofocus sucks on G7X. Like it will take seconds and seconds to focus, but for Sony, it is very easy to focus. And about the screen, ZV-1 has like those side open screens. And when you're vlogging, you're like looking this way. So the footage you have is like your eyes are slightly tilted like sideways. It would be a little bit strange like to have yourself constantly looking on that direction. But for Canon, it's like flip upwards. So you're like looking a little bit upwards. On that part, I personally love Canon better. And it just looked more natural because I'm a person that who will constantly look at the screen to check if I look good. And moving on to the lens, both lens has wide angles. It has 24 millimeter angles because you're like holding it right here and you want your face to be on the screen. But personally speaking, I think Canon has wider lens than Sony. I don't know why, even though I have this Ulanzi wide angle macro, it will make your lens like 80 millimeters, but I think it's not wide enough for me. I don't know, maybe I just have short arms that is not long enough. And also ZV-1 has built-in ND filters, which is really rare to have on small cameras like these when you're like outdoor under a very strong sunlight. With that ND filter, it will make your image much better. So if you're like a beginner to vlogs, I would recommend you to use your phone first and then upgrade to Canon. And if you're like looking for a better quality in vlogs and you value audios, autofocus, or a more effective workflow, then choose ZV-1. I think audio is very important in vlogging. A lot of people ignore that, but it is definitely what people should pay attention to. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. And please stay tuned for our next video. Bye.